The future of Camden City will not be built of brick and mortar alone. At the 6th Camden Environmental Summit at Rutgers Camden, rebuilding from the ground up is taken quite literally. Mayor Frank Moran was a keynote speaker.
First and foremost, Camden was an industrial city. We've done a lot of remediation over the last 25 years. Today, there is a lot of brick and mortar going up in the city of Camden, and simultaneously, we're addressing the infrastructure to control the flooding, to educate folks the importance of green and recycling and anything that has to do with improving the environment, and that's our goal.
The irony of this waterfront city is that the water can often end up everywhere. The result of an antiquated combined sewer system that the Camden Collaborative Initiative, which presented today's program, hopes to eliminate by 2020.
Because we have a combined sewer system, an old sewer system in the city of Camden, we do have a lot of instances of flooding of wastewater into our parks, into people's homes, into roadways, which really is a quality of life issue for the residents of the city.
It's a collaborative effort. It takes a village to make a great city great again. And nowhere is that more visible than with the work of the Camden Power Corps, the members of which were honored today.
We maintain rain gardens around the city. We clean the inlets in the city so that the storm water doesn't mix with the rainwater on the streets and overflood, because Camden has a lot of flooding problems. I think it's very important for like young adults of Camden to take it back, because we're here right now, like we're the future. So, I mean, if the younger kids see us taking heed and getting the environment together now, and maybe along the lines they'll come on and do the same thing.
Longtime Camden environmental activist Olivia Glenn was also recognized for her work in the city. She now runs the Division of Parks and Forestry at the state DEP.
When you take an investment in improving your environment, it certainly builds the gateway to be engaged civically in other matters. So I think that it is wonderful to have them involved, and I look forward to seeing a lot from them in their future.
In the end, a cleaner, greener environment is critical to a city's economic viability. Former Governor Jim Florio was the congressman who authored the Superfund legislation.
And this event today is extremely important. And it's most interesting because it seems to put the lie to the whole idea that somehow the environment and economic development can't be compatible. That's obviously not the truth. That Camden, which is going through a massive redevelopment project that is doing very much to enhance the well-being of people here, is also demonstrating environmental sensitivity.
There's still a lot here that needs cleaning up. Not all of it has to do with the natural environment. But the foundation is set here, where Camdenites are taking efforts into their own hands and doing what they can, hoping to set an example for the rest of the city to follow. In Camden, I'm David Cruz, NJTV News.